Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Ali, and today I'm going to speak on childhood memories. We all have different kinds of and lots of childhood memories. I belong to an Indian middle class family. My dad had a job, and he used to work from morning to night. My mom did part-time job. This was when I was back in Abu Dhabi. Abu Dhabi is a city in UAE. So in my childhood, children are 5 years old, and we used to go to mall for shopping. And every time I used to find some toy which I always wanted to buy. It could be any kind of a video game or something else. And I used to first ask, and I used to request, I used to plead, and then I used to cry loudly, I want it. And then the only thing my dad would do is hold me so that I couldn't go anywhere else. And then the only thing he would say was, we will buy it later. And that later would never come. Less did I know that I was being trained to live in situations when you don't have stuff that you want, so that you appreciate it when you finally get it. So there was one fine evening when we went to the mall, and again I saw this amazing video game. This was back in 1999, and it was on an offer. So it's a pile of video games, and on top of that, looking very beautiful. So it was a plastic video game. You know the ones you put cassettes? Yeah, the Mario games. So I took that, and the same thing, I have to ask my dad. And what he would say again, we'll buy it later. So this time, rather than being more excited, I was more anxious. So I went to him and I asked him, Dad, can we buy this? It's okay if we don't buy this today, but it's on an offer. I was literally requesting. And he looked at me, he gave a pause, and then he said, okay. He picked up the video game and put it in the trolley. That was an amazing feeling. That whole time while we were shopping around, I was smiling. Then we were in the car, when we went home, we had dinner, and then I got a chance to open the box. I opened the box, we have the red, yellow, and white cable. I connected those to the video game and to the TV, the controller, and I played my first game, Road Fighter. The ones in which we need fuel to go ahead. And then that was something else, that experience was completely different. But today I realized that even when my father was saying that you don't need it, and I was saying why, I realized that I appreciated that game more because I got it at a later time. And if I would have got it the first time I would have asked, maybe I wouldn't have appreciated it that much. So that is what I had learned in my childhood. My dad used to see in areas of physical activity, of when I wanted to buy a cycle. I had 4 cycles in 8 years. I had a normal cycle, I had a standing cycle, I had an electric cycle. And then I got a proper cycle when I was 10 or 11 years old. And he used to ask me one thing, that promise me that you will ride this cycle and not keep it in the balcony. And I would say, yes, I promise, I want the cycle. And then we in Abu Dhabi, so on the side of the sea, there's a huge Cornish, about 5 to 6 kilometers. So I used to take the cycle. Many times I would go with my friends, and sometimes I would go alone. I would take it to huge, 4 kilometers, 5 kilometers, and then I would ride cycle a lot. And that actually helped me to use motorcycles when I came to Mumbai. So I learned how to balance a cycle. I feel that people should learn 2 things, cycling and swimming. I'm not too good at swimming, but cycling is something which everyone should know. So with this, I'm very blessed to have a father like him, and dad, I love you.